Hello everyone, this is Gold Mage Ace, Eric, talking Gaming Rant number 2. So let's get going with this rant on a free online game from the IJJI network, Gunbound Revolution. Now I've been playing this game for a solid 2 years, and let me just say before we begin that I've recently been stripped for my ability to play, but I'll be getting back into the water as soon as I've learned the pool's been cleansed via radiation. Last time I talked about Age of Empires 2, a game which requires incessant attention, IED, for military strategy, and a needless amount of micromanaging skills in order to play. True that Gunbound Revolution requires the same IED mentality to play, but focuses a lot more on one's ability to calculate wind, power, distance, and use memory to remember turn order. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Gunbound Revolution is a free online game that is much like playing Pocket Tanks, with various simple machines. It's a game that requires one to remember variations of strategy, wind changes, and turn order. Gunbound is played on a two-dimensional plane with varying levels of height. Mobiles are selected or put at random, and the object of the game is, for the most part, to pelt your enemies with whatever projectile you are using until they cannot pelt you back. It will be the job of geometry professionals to calculate angles, the job of mathematicians to determine how much damage they will do, the job of geology majors to determine how to get around tornadoes, and the job of psychologists to scoff at opponents who forget to use the dual item. You heard me correct, YouTubers. Gunbound requires you to pick an angle, hold the spacebar until you think you have enough power, release, and pray that your shot hits your opponents rather than your teammates. A difficult part of this game happens to be the teammates, if I might make a bold, refined statement, in the wake of a not-so-sudden realization that I might as well put this in the rant as well. The majority of players who play Gunbound seem to be a combination of three things: trolls, idiots, and cheaters. Allow me to make a simulation for you. Imagine you are on a four-person team with three of all these character types. Whenever you miss a shot, the troll could call you anything he wants: a homosexual, a Jew, retarded, or any manner of needless, sensitive terms which I mean no offense by, but they just might. With the end of your turn, the idiot's turn begins, and instead of hitting an opponent on the other side of the map, suffice to say he undershoots and hits you twice, since he feels the dual item on turn one is necessary. Having ended his turn, the troll calls him some term, and the cheater on your side makes a brilliant shot, which hits an opponent dead on and twice, while the troll calls him a cheater, perhaps rightly so, and pretty soon everybody on your team is in a dead heat against each other. The cheater continues to play well, having been cheating. The troll continues to shoot at the idiot, who tries to shoot back at the troll and hits you. And fairly soon it doesn't matter how much your cheater knows about the aimbot sequencing, because it's become 4 versus 2 against you. Even if you don't get a situation which is the perfect apple pie I just described, you may be constantly left with custard pie, in which your opponents are of the few flavors I just described, which would mean you're constantly being pelted with trolling comments, idiots whining about how you're double-teaming them, game masters banning your expendable items and threatening to kick you should you even think about using them, and finally the banning of broken mobiles for being so broken. It makes Gunbound a difficult game to play during your leisure time, because it calls to mind the question of whether or not it's actually a leisure activity at all. I played in the Avatar off zone so that rich boys couldn't end up buying overpowered items and smack me around like a drunken fly. But today I see maybe 5 out of 1,000 people playing in the Avatar off zone merely because they can get an overpowered item just by going through the tutorial. You may ask me, Eric, why not just use your expendable items that you earned by being so gosh darn good? Well, avid listener, I would. It's just that half the time these guys don't like the idea of expendable items, and I'm coming around myself. It's enough that some mobiles are better than others. Locked into close range with Bigfoot, you're a goner. Locked into long range against Cal, and you're a goner. Locked on a bunch map against JD, and you're a goner. Locked into any map against Grub, and this person isn't gonna miss. One problem down. But it gets worse when you're sitting around, ready to play some Gunbound. You hit a great shot, and then your opponent rolls within a centimeter of you, uses a damage multiplier, and kills you both. Before you know it, he spawned right on top of you again, and uses the damage multiplier again, and you're both dead again. If he's that much of an asshole, he may even use a shield item at a crucial point in the game to receive no damage, or he may use a healing item to heal himself, or he may use lava or poison gas to even the odds while he's dead. I've had my fun using expendable items, but I always had the decency to use them after only someone used them against me first. If someone wants to play hardball, I encourage you to play hardball back. Overall, they can be great fun. They're just overpowered at times and an annoyance when someone insists upon using them tactlessly. Speaking of tactlessly, there's a reason some players should listen to their teammates before condemning them to death. I've had it up to here with players trying to shoot upslope with Grub in the hopes that it won't roll down and smash them. I don't like watching Bigfoot players shoot an enemy inches away from me just to watch us both die in a pit. It's just as bad when someone picks Cal and doesn't know how to high angle, or Ace-8 who is stuck in a tight hole and has to shoot his way out with a weapon, but insists upon weapon 2 because it just works better, you sick bastards, I'm talking about a game. Seriously, Gunbound players, use some common sense and we'll all get along just fine. Overall, Gunbound is frustrating. I won't say that it's not. You already have to calculate plenty of variables in your head, and all these other strange variables get thrown at you from time to time, which force you to play like a master if you want any recognition at all. To the trolls, go back to drinking alcohol. To the idiots, stop whining, sit there, and shut up. To the cheaters, it's only a matter of time before that maintenance comes up. And to you, the attentive general audience, trust me when I say Gunbound is a great game if you can get past it all. I have patience, but it's not the patience of a saint, and anybody could tell you that I, like others, have the capacity to become greatly irritated. But the game is addictive and great fun, even if you lose. I encourage you to go out there and play. And if you want someone competent to play with, I'm sure I'll have my account back up soon, with the guild page willing to play as well. Add Percival THD for more info. Thanks for listening, and happy Ark. Mage, Knack, Lightning, JD, Ace-8, J-Frog, Kelsodon, Trico, Bigfoot, Boomer, Ice, Turtle, Grub, Rayon, Aduka, Maya, Wolf, Phoenix, Dragon, Knight, Frank, Whale, and Tiburon.